Lord, have mercy. I felt the presence of the Lord in this place. He's here, folks. He's here. That feeling that you're feeling is just not coincidental. It's just not feel-good bumps. But what that is, that's the Holy Spirit going to and fro through this place, trying to bless you. And the Bible says that all you have to do is reach out and receive from God, and He will bless you beyond measure. Some of you may need healing this morning. You may need salvation this morning in your heart. You must be born again. You must know Jesus as your personal Savior. You must know, even if you're lost, that we are living in the very last of the very last days. You must know that something's going on with all of our weather patterns. You must know that the sun's beginning to get hot. You must be able to see the signs that God is sending His church, saying it's almost time for the bride to split the eastern skies. It's almost time for Him to bust the clouds of glory open and the church to go home. It's almost time, church. Hold on with all your might to Jesus Christ, your Lord and your Savior. Hold on with your deep walk with God. Don't let nobody tell you you're a Jesus freak. Just agree with Him and say, you're right. I'm sold out to Jesus. I love Him with all of my heart, all of my soul, and all of my mind. He's been good to me. He's been good to my family. He raised me up when this world shut me off. He raised me up when the church hurt my heart. Jesus was there to lift me up. And I'll serve Him until the day that I die. St. John, we're going to read just a little bit this morning. Promise I won't keep you long at all. We've already been to church, praise God. The book of St. John, chapter 15. The book of St. John, chapter 15. If you don't have your Bibles this morning, look on with your friend. If your friend don't have their Bible,
change friends.
We've got to have the Word of God with us. The Word of God in chapter 15, starting with verse 1, reads like this. I am the true vine. This is Jesus talking. My Father is the husband. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, He taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, He purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. Say, Jesus is the vine. I am the branch. Now, people nowadays think that there's no need for the vine. They think that we've got beyond in this modern society that we don't need the vine anymore, speaking of Jesus, that we can do things on our own. But I want to make a quick example to you this morning, saying that the vine can live without the branches, but the branches can't live without the
Come on.
Let's say that one more time. The vine can live without the branches, but the branches can't live without
the vine.
The vine, praise God. And we think in our modern society that we've got so intelligent and so knowledgeable that we no more need to go to our knees and thank Jesus, the very vine. I remember one time in my yard, I cut a tree all the way down to the ground, and many of you have probably done this, and the stump was sticking up about maybe 1 inch. The next day or the next day, I went out there and there was a little bitty sprout growing off of that vine. Amen. We are the branch. He is the vine. I want you to remember that. And I also want you to remember this. The vine don't need you, but you need desperately, more than ever, you need the vine. You need Jesus, especially in these times. I feel sorry for folks that don't have any hope in their life. They have no way or nothing to go to in this life except their self, their friends, CNN and Fox News. I'm glad that I can go beyond all of that and I can go into the throne room of God for the answers in these last days. And those answers only come from the vine. God prunes us sometimes The word said he purges us. That means that it's going to hurt sometimes to live this life. It's not always going to be rosy and not always going to be easy. You're going to be persecuted, and God's going to cut off the branches of your branch to make you a stronger branch so that you can bring forth good fruit in your life. Jesus taught like this. I believe I'll just teach like Jesus. I don't want to hear from no man. I don't want to hear their informational values of their life, but I want to hear from God Almighty Himself. For through the vine is the only way that I'm going to be blessed. It's the only way that I'm going to be blessed is to reach out to an Almighty God and know without a shadow of a doubt that He's here in this place. The branches seem to think you can cut a tree down in your yard, or I'm sorry, you can prune a tree and cut all the branches off of them. And the next day, them leaves on those branches are going to turn brown. They're not going to last, and they're going to wither, and they're going to die, because that branch sustains its strength from the trunk or the vine of whatever it's growing on. That's how God set up this perfect designed world, so that we can even look at very nature itself. We can look at a tree and say, without that vine or without that trunk, those branches would die. That's like my life as I'm hanging there. If I try to separate myself from the tree or the vine, I'm going to die and wither up. Some folks are separated from the vine and don't even know it. You know what I'm talking about? The first church of the refrigerator. Some of you have been to one of them. I know I've been to a lot of them. And they choose to separate themselves from the vine to follow religious ceremonies. And they get their program in their hand when they come in the door, and they say, well, I know exactly what we're going to do today. I'm glad I put the pot roast on. I'm glad I can go home and cook spaghetti. We even going to have time to go to the lake today. We may not have time to run by Six Flags a little later on, because this church only lasts 35 minutes. We know exactly what's going to go on. We're going to open in prayer. We're going to sing two hymnals. The preacher's going to get up and put all of us to sleep, and then somebody going to dismiss in prayer. That's the way it is every Sunday in some places. But I refuse to have church like that. I refuse to have church where God Almighty is not in charge of the service. Well, you see, we are nothing without the vine. We are only the branches. And we are so privileged to be the branches of the vine. God didn't choose something else to be the branches. He didn't choose the animals to be the branches. For He said we would have dominion over all the things that He created on earth. He didn't choose this carpet to be the branches. He didn't choose cars and homes to be the branches. But praise God, He looked way down in the portals of the future, and He seen you, and He loved you, and He said, you're beautiful. You are the branch of the vine. I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. You remember that old song? Some of you, I thought that number one would surely be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. I thought I could do a lot on my own, but I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. I left out a sentence, but some of y'all ain't with me anyway, so praise God, just pray for me a little bit here. I like this book, the book of John. I want to read that one more time, the verse 1. Jesus said, I am. The true vine. And my Father is the husbandman. Praise God, He is. He said, I am. The same words that when Moses went forth, I'm closing. Come on, man. Come on up here, praise and worship team. When Moses went forth and saw the burning bush, some people, they don't believe in being slain in the spirit. But the Bible says when men come into the glory of God, sometimes they're slain in the spirit. Listen, my wife was raised Catholic to the bone. When she married me, she thought I was crazier than a loon. Looney Tunes. Her mom and daddy thought I done brainwashed her. They said, oh my God, he's one of them cults. They done sucked you in, Bridget. You were raised Catholic, you know better. We went to a service one night, and I said, come on up with me, baby. The preacher's going to pray for people. And she said, I'm not falling out like them nutty Pentecostals. And we're not Pentecostal, we're non-denominational, but I'm just using that for information, all right? But that's exactly what she said. And my wife is hard-headed. She will not do something by herself. It's got to be the power of God before she will make a move, because she don't want to do anything in her own flesh. We went up in front of that church, and she was standing beside me, and there's about 15 people. You know where the church is at? Danny's church, Zach and Rooney, down on 41. Pastor Danny started from the end. He went to praying for people. And as he touched them folks and prayed, they began to fall backwards, and I could see Bridget's eyes. She's enrolling them. She's at all one of them services. I know all about this now. I'm not falling out. You can see her tensing up, like she was leaning kind of forward, daring him to push her backwards. I am not falling down. These people are crazy. Pastor Danny got about 5 people from her. Said, in the name of Jesus, you are blessed. Peace be with you always. And that man laid his hands on that woman's head, and 5 people down, Bridget fell out in the spirit. Needless to say, she believes. And I can't understand people that even try to do those things on their own without the help of the vine. Let me tell you something. There is gifts of God. I'm closing, I promise. There's gifts from God, but they have to be through the vine. They have to be used through Jesus. You can't say, I came from a traditional church, but I'm broke from all of that now, and then bring your tradition to church. Amen. Just because you fell out yesterday don't mean you're going to fall out today. Listen, church, hear, and you'll hear the word. You'll hear the word. God's going to work with you differently every time. Every time you go into His presence, He's going to show you something new. He's going to show you something fresh. For His freshness, His I Am, never gets old. There's always something new around the next bend when you're serving with Jesus. Just hold on to the plow. God's got something new for you in store that's going to bless you beyond measure. Be careful what you say. Oh, I've heard people say, I'll never say I should have bought a Honda. Next thing you know, they're talking about Chevrolets in another language. You didn't buy a Honda, but you sure got a hold of something that sounds like Chevrolet. God fooled you. Duh! The Lord. If you'll only reach out and say, God, I believe that you are the vine. I'm only the branch. I can do nothing without you, God. For you said I would be hewn down and thrown into the fire if I didn't trust in you. But I'm putting all my trust this morning in the vine. Every new thing that He has for me, I want it all. I want every blessing, every healing. I want to see salvation in every service. I want to see the vine working through the people of God. Give the Lord a shout. Woo! I don't know why I wore a jacket. The vine. Do you know the vine this morning? Do you know the one that wrote the precious word of God? Do you know the I Am that this verse speaks about? Do you know when Jesus said, I Am, and when God said, I Am, in front of Moses, what He was saying is, I am the one that formed the stars and the heavens. I am the one that will send my son to die on the cross. I am the one that will shed the blood so that every human being that is lost and undone and don't know me can come to know me in the free pardon of sin. I am the one that puts the dance under your feet. I am the one that puts the shout in your mouth. I am the one that you will lift your hands and praise me. I am the vine. I will abide in him. Glory. Well, that scared the fire of some of you. Woo, I can't help it. I feel excited. I didn't even feel good this morning.
Amen.
But I'm glad that I know him. Would you bow your heads in this place? Father God, we come to you in the precious name of Jesus. Lord, time is so short. We just get to having church and then it's time to end. But we know, Lord, that someday we'll be in your presence always. For eternity, eternity, eternity. That Father God, you are the true vine in our lives. You are the one who sets free and who saves. If there's one in here today that's been looking around this morning and you see these folks all excited and dancing and doing puppet shows and children running around this church with praise flags, they've got something to praise about. They know the one that set them free. They know Jesus Christ as their Savior and as their friend. You may not know him this morning. You don't even have to get up out of your seat to know Jesus. But I need to know who I'm praying for. Can somebody say, Pastor Bobby, I need your prayers. I don't know this Jesus. God bless you. I see. Is there another one? Is there another one? Just raise your hand. I don't know this. I really want to make sure that I know Jesus in my life. I really want to make sure. Come on, lift your hands. There's one more here. That your heartstrings or your chest is busted wide open. You need to know Jesus as your personal Savior. I want the whole church to look at me right now. I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Jesus, I am a sinner. Come into my heart. I believe, Lord, that you came to the earth in the flesh. I believe, Lord Jesus, that you died on the cross. And I believe on the third day you were resurrected from the dead. Forgive me of my sins, Lord. Come into my heart. Save me. Set me free. Heal my physical and my spiritual self right now in your name. Amen and amen. Let's give the Lord a hand this morning. You didn't raise your hand. Every devil in hell is trying to come against you. You're saved by the blood of Jesus. You never forget that. You know him as your personal Savior. Now, God's going to begin working with you and maturing you in your walk in the name of Jesus. Someone else needs a healing in here this morning. We're going to close. Minister Bobby, I'd like you to sing Shepherd's Call if you would. Somebody needs a healing in their body. Would you come forth? Would you come forth? The doctors that give you a bad report, I'm here to tell you that God can heal you this very day. Christians, would you come and help us pray? Just stand behind these. Someone else, someone else. Someone says, Pastor Bobby, I want to be baptized with the Holy Spirit. I want to begin experience the gift of God. Come on, come on up, come on up. Praise God. There's several of you that are sick in your body. You need prayer this morning. Don't tell me what it is. Don't tell me what it is. When you come up here, just lift your hands in the air and begin praising Jesus. Father God, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, for this sister. Oh, God, begin to heal her from the top of her head to the very soles of her feet. In the name of Jesus, we feel your spirit right here, Lord, and we thank you for your spirit. Father God, feel her. Feel her until the cup overflows. In your precious name, by your precious stripes, we pray this prayer. We agree as one in your names. Amen and amen. Just thank him, sir. Just thank him. Just thank him. Someone else. Someone else. Let's pray. Just lift your hands, sister. Just already, Lord, go to thank you. Just say thank you, Jesus. Lift his hand up. Moses got tired in the wilderness and he couldn't raise his hands up. And the people stood behind Moses and raised his hands for him. When you see a brother or sister that can't raise their hands anymore, raise their hands for them. Raise raise their hands up. Help them. Help them to praise Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we curse this infirmity in the name of Jesus. By your stripes, Lord, you said that we are healed. We claim that in your precious name this morning, Father God. And we praise you ahead of time. For this is in the name of Jesus. We pray. Amen and amen. And someone else. Sister Sherry, would you begin praying in the heavenly language? Just stretch your hands this way. Everybody that would, just stretch your hands this way. Just pray. Begin praying. Just begin praying. Father God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray this prayer. Father God, we ask you for complete healing. For Sister Kathy to be made whole in her body, Lord, and in her mind. In the name of Jesus. In the precious, precious name of Jesus. We claim this right now. There it is. It's in the name of Jesus. Fill her with your love and your glory right now. In your name we claim this. Amen and amen. Someone else need prayer. The chains of speech. Father God, in the name of Jesus, touch this woman. She's been walking with you for a long time. Jesus. The devil has tried to make her road crooked. Father God, we ask you to straighten that road this morning in your precious name. Father God, heal her from the top of her head to the soles of her feet. Let her loved ones be healed. Let them begin to come to church, Lord. Let them begin to just get hungry for your righteousness, Lord. Father God, and we praise you and we give you the honor for this prayer. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Right there it is. Right there it is. Someone else. Whatever this sickness is, we curse it in your name, Lord. We don't even have to know the name. We just know that you are in control, Lord. And Father God, that you can heal any infirmity. We trust in you, Lord, without even seeing. We trust in you. You said that your children will be blessed with a double portion. We ask for a double portion in this life. In your precious name, we pray this prayer. Amen and amen. Praise God. You go home and tell him everything will be okay. In the name of Jesus, we pray for a healing right now. Right now, Lord, we know that this is miles away, but we know that you can heal miles away, Lord. We know that you're the same God there in Cairo. In Cairo, as you are here in Gardner. In the name of Jesus, we pray this prayer. In healing his body, make him whole, Lord. Also this mother, make her whole, Lord. Make her whole in the name of Jesus. We believe with all of our heart as my brother stands in as a vessel. In the name of Jesus, amen. Just praise him, church. Just praise him. Yes, God. Yes, Father God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive right now, sister. Father God, in the name of Jesus, a complete healing. Complete healing, Lord. Father God, we give you the honor and the glory and the praise in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Right there it is in the name of Jesus. Receive, receive, receive from the Lord. Someone else. Yes, baby. Lift your hand. Your back hurts. Well, lift your hands up, sweetheart. Say thank you, Jesus. Just say thank you, Jesus, to yourself. Father God, we ask you to heal this back of this child. In the precious name of Jesus, begin to heal this back and don't let it hurt anymore. In the name of Jesus. Right there it is, baby. You just keep on believing. God just healed your back. Look at me. Look at me. Jesus loves you, baby. Jesus loves you, okay? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Give her a hand, church. Nothing more precious than a child coming for prayer. Can you lift both hands, sweetheart? Father God, in the name of Jesus, heal my sister from the top of her head to the very soles of her feet. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we're trusting you for a miracle, Lord. We ask for a miracle in this life right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, that you do it in her life, that she'll have no doubt that it was by your hand that this miracle was done. In the name of Jesus, we give you all the honor, praise, and glory. Amen and amen. Just thank him, sister. Just thank him in the name of Jesus. Just thank him. Someone else. Yes. we pray for this stomach right now. In the name of Jesus, Father God, begin to ease the pain. Whatever it is, we curse it in your name, Lord. You said, Lord Jesus, by your stripes that we shall be, not that we might or maybe, but we shall be healed. Lord, your vessel is standing here in need, and we ask it all in your name right now, in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Be made whole, sister. Be made whole in the name of Jesus. Right there's your healing in the name of Jesus. Someone else. Someone else. Someone else. We're not going to quit praying. We may run out of time, but we're not going to quit praying. Lift your hands. Father God, in the name of Jesus, set her free. Send this sister free in the name of somebody. Stand behind her, please. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, set her free, Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, the devil has tried to tell her that she's a nobody. But Father God, she has royal blood running through her veins. She's somebody in the kingdom of God. She is the apple of your eye, Lord, and we pray for her right now for power and strength to come over her life and peace that passes all understanding. In the name of Jesus, we pray. There it is, sister. Just receive it. Just receive it and say, thank you, Lord. Just receive it. It's all right. Just receive it. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. Come here. Come here. You don't need to fall. You don't need to fall. We got you. We got you. Praise God. Just thank him. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Just thank him. Just thank him. Just say thank you, Jesus. I know you received something in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father God. Someone else. Someone else. Lift your hands, sweetheart. Father God, in the name of Jesus, bless this sister in her life in a mighty way, Lord. Father, you've already brought her a long way, and I ask in your name. I ask in your name, Lord, to show her a miracle in her life. Father God, that nobody can see. That nobody else can see. Everybody else has told her it's not possible. But Father God, we know through you that all things are possible. In the name of Jesus, we ask this. We ask this and we believe, Lord, in your name. Amen and amen. It's going to be done, Sister Pat. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Can you say in the name of Jesus?
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Lift your hands. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, she stands in. Brother DJ, every hand this way, if you would. Every hand this way. Pray with us. Just believe with us. Just believe with us for a few more moments. Just a few more moments. Father God, in the name of Jesus, strength, Lord, strength. Father God, in the precious, precious name of Jesus, this precious soul, Lord, as he reaches out for you, strengthen his heart. Strengthen his mind, Lord Jesus, as he begins to understand your word more. Father God, in this vessel, this honor that stands in for him, Lord, that she'll be blessed in a mighty way in her life. In the name of Jesus, we pray this prayer. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. You've had your heart broken over something. God, mend that heartbreak. Forget that past. Forget that past. You're having trouble forgetting it. Forget it. Look forward in the Lord. Don't look back. Look forward at the cross. Stop looking back. There's nothing behind us. It's all forward in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Give the Lord some honor with the clap. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Oh, God, the Lord's good this morning. He's so wonderful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Minister Bobby sings this morning. We're going to take up our Sunday morning tithes and offerings. Please give as you have been blessed in this church. Please give. Brother Randy, could you come forward? Minister Billy, would you help us with the offering this morning, please? Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for this vessel. We thank you, Father. Peace of mind, Lord. Peace of mind that the devil so many times has tried to